One of the more popular effects when talking about photography is something called the Orton effect, and you've definitely seen this even if you didn't know what it was called. This is that sort of bright and hazy, dreamy look that you tend to associate with like landscapes and sort of fantasy-ish work. It's cool and it's popular for a reason, right? One of the big questions though is, can we replicate that look in video? And the answer is yeah, and it's really pretty easy. Let's go into Premiere. Like I said, this effect is really easy to apply. First things first, obviously get your footage on the timeline, and then you want to create a duplicate of that footage by holding either Alt or Option, depending whether you're Windows or Mac, and then click and drag the duplicate up to the V2 layer. Once you have your duplicate in the V2 layer, you're going to go to the Effects tab, and you're going to look for Gaussian Blur. Apply that to your V2 layer. Now, the amount of blur you add here in the Effect Controls tab is going to determine how crazy this looks here in just a second. I tend to go between 50 and 70 if I'm trying to do this look. For this footage, I'm gonna go with 70. Now, immediately, this does not look like what we want, right? It's super blurry, you can't see anything, it's not right. What we're gonna do now, though, is we're gonna change the blend mode of this V2 layer to screen, so that it's overlaying and it's brightening and just blending these two layers together. Now, I tend to then take the opacity of this V2 layer that we're now screening on top, I tend to take it down to about 75%, just so that we have some of the original footage flying through a little easier, right? And really, that's about as far as most people go, and you could be done there and just call this good, but I like to go one step further by creating an adjustment layer. So new item, adjustment layer, drag it out over your footage, and then, once you've got your adjustment layer in place, I like to go to Lumetri Color, which if the window is not already visible, you can get it from the Windows tab up at the very top there. And I like to up my contrast, drop my shadows, and drop my blacks to bring in some more contrast back into this image, just to give it a little more detail that we've lost with the blur and the overlay. I also like to up my saturation a little bit just because I like high saturation content. And there you have the Orton effect for video. Like I said, quick, easy, and it adds a nice sort of dreamlike look to your footage. So play with it and keep shooting.